How's it going, guys? It's Fisayo here, and in this video we'll be talking about the new Vivo Y20. This is the newest addition to the Y series lineup, and I'll be taking you through the specs and features and all of the things about this device that I find quite interesting. This Vivo Y20 in my hands is the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage version, retailing for 69,900 naira, which is $152, and there's a lesser version with 3GB of RAM for 65,900 naira, $143. So what do you get for a sub $150 smartphone? That and more will be covered in this video. If you want to check out parts of this video that is relevant to you, simply check out the timestamps for different chapters of this video in the description or in the chapter section. Without further ado, let's get to the video. When it comes to the unboxing experience of the Y20, the first thing you get is a smaller box with paperwork and the SIM ejector tool. Right underneath it is the device itself, and you do get a protective film on the 6.51 inch front display. Of course, it's glass and plastic mesh, and we'll come to it later. As far as accessories, you do get a huge charging brick, and this phone is capable of 18 watt flash charge, aka fast charge, so it gets this huge 5000 mAh battery only up to 70% in little over an hour, specifically 1 hour and 9 minutes, which is cool. You also get a regular USB cable and wired headphones. Booting into PhoneTouch OS 10.5 on the Vivo Y20 took a little over 34 seconds, which is just good enough for phones in this range, and the OS seems smooth with the custom skin. When it comes to build quality and design materials of the Vivo Y20, as I mentioned, you do get glass screen and polycarbonate back or plastic back, which is good in case it drops. It's only 192 grams, so it's pretty fair. Color options for the Vivo Y20 are mainly three. There's the obsidian black, there's the dawn white, and purest blue. I got to play with the black and the blue version, which we have here, but the dawn white seems quite premium based on these ones I've had in my hand. When it comes to ports and IO, we've got the fingerprint reader, which also is the power button. I'm a fan of this design, but you know, it's become popular as of late. I also like that it's a different shade of blue on this obsidian blue version. The power button is a different shade of blue. Above it is the volume record keys. We've got the SIM and micro SD card slot to the left side. It's the dual SIM kind, it's not hybrid, so you can put your micro SD card and SIMs with no issues. Underneath the phone is the headphone jack, microphone, charging port, and speaker. Up top is where you have the earpiece with the camera in the water drop notch, and on the back is where you get the rectangular back camera array section with the design for Y series inscription and the logo right below. Indeed, the back of the phone and even the display are fingerprint magnets, so there's that to note. Speaking of the display on this device, you do have 6.51 inch LCD IPS display, pretty industry standard for mid-range markets, and it puts a water drop notch on the screen. It's got a 2.5D curved glass going on, and the aspect ratio on here is 20:9 resolution, HD plus set at 1600x720, and if you're gauging it, it's just medium density at 270 ppi or pixel per inch. You've also got dark mode on here. I found watching and streaming videos to be good on here and overall enjoyable. For a market like ours where data is quite expensive, this is a consideration for people who will be conserving their data, since maximum streaming resolution is 720p up to 60fps, so there's that to note. You do notice that the bottom bezel is very apparent too. I also found gameplay resolution to be sharp as well, despite being a 720p screen. I didn't feel like I missed anything. Sound quality on the Vivo Y20 is okay as well. It's got a single speaker at the bottom, and you can actually block it if you place your hands over it during gameplay or when you're watching videos. So that's something to note. You might want to invest in wireless headphones or use the headphones that came with the Vivo Y20 that is included in the box. It sounded decent and loud, and it wasn't scratched up or anything, so that's a plus. Call quality was fine, text and voiceover internet was fine as well, and people on the other side will hear you clearly. You've got Android 10 on here, skinned with PhoneTouch OS 10.5. Processor on here is the Qualcomm Snapdragon 460, an 11 nanometer octa-core processor, similar to a couple of mid-range smartphones in this price range. RAM and ROM options vary for the Y20, as I mentioned earlier. In this video, this version right here in my hand is the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage version, as I mentioned earlier, almost 70k or $152. There's a lesser 3GB RAM for 65.9 or 66k if you round it up. That's $143. If you're buying anyone, I'd suggest to get the higher version, which is this one. It's pretty responsive, it works smoothly for me, and PhoneTouch OS wasn't limiting for me, as I did find more useful features, especially in the settings. And you know, when I wanted to game, there was a feature where you can slide your three fingers up to access text message during gameplay if you don't want to quit the app immediately, or you can slide your three fingers down to take a screenshot. Speaking of gameplay and gaming quality on the Vivo Y20, graphics was the default medium for Call of Duty, which is what I always used to test. I didn't notice any lags. It did get slightly warm to the touch, but it was nothing serious at all. And gameplay was overall enjoyable, graphically and in terms of performance. Now, you do get a 5000 mAh battery on here, which has been good enough for me personally. I found standby time to be good as well, and I also found usability for day-to-day quite good when it comes to light use. Heavy use would also get you to a couple of hours left during the day. 30 minutes of gaming Call of Duty specifically took only 6% of the battery life out. From 51%, it went down to 45%. When it matters of charging, I found the fast charger to be fast, of course, although I do wish we had USB-C on here, but this does the job. You should get enough power to last you for over 50% of the next day till you need to charge, and I really did like the standby performance of the Y20. Something interesting that you also get is reverse charging. Basically, with an OTG cable, you'll be able to power up your other devices. I mean, you've got a 5000 mAh battery on here, so not only do you have enough power for your own phone, you've got enough power for another device. As far as other features that come with the Vivo Y20, you've got Bluetooth 5.0. Again, the fingerprint reader that's side mounted works pretty fast. Same with face unlock as well, but I preferred using the fingerprint reader on the side more, especially in these times where we're wearing face masks and people might not want to remove their face masks, especially if they're in public. When it comes to the camera, up front, it's a modest 8-megapixel front-facing camera that will shoot a maximum of 1080p video in 30 frames per second. The back has a triple camera setup, 13-megapixel wide, 2-megapixel macro, and 2-megapixel depth sensor. Okay, but how does it perform? I would say that selfie quality alongside the front-facing portrait mode was actually impressive when there is enough light. During the day, you will get the best selfies, especially if there is not so much exposure on the background and the background is not so far from the subject. There are still more modes on the front camera, in panorama mode for group selfies and live photo mode, which does a short video alongside the photo taking, and you can press and hold to play it. When it comes to the back camera, you do get some decent shots out of this camera. The reds are a bit more pronounced in enough light, and you'll notice the punch in colors, and the reds, as I mentioned, do stand out. In portrait mode, on the same flower, you can get the background blurred in the shot, and you can also adjust the blur level of the shot before you share it. You can see that you can adjust it all the way from f16, which has basically no bokeh, up to f0.95, which simulates a lot of light coming in and allows for a lot of background blur. In macro mode, you do get the opportunity of being close to your subject as possible, and you can see here, as with the texture on the pillow, on the YouTube pillow, you see a lot of patterns. For the rose, I was super close, and if you don't pixel peep and look at it from a distance, it does look usable. I took another macro mode shot, and I practically had the camera of the lens on top of the stones, and it still picked the textures of the stone. It was consistent among all the shots I took, and I think it's commendable, you know, that it's a 2-megapixel macro camera. I would have loved it to be higher, and you know, with the shots I took, but you do get some usable images out of this camera. As far as textures and shooting a larger subject, you can notice the clarity in the clouds and on the ground. There's no telephoto camera on here, so everything you see is digital zooming, and the digital zoom is up to 4x, but with 1 and 2x selection modes. The 2x mode is where it gets a little blurry. You do notice some noise to compensate, and it's the same with 4x. Again, with textures and zooms, you get the quote-unquote best images with 1x lens or the still 13 megapixel camera when it's not zoomed. The same pattern is noticed when you zoom. However, here in this image with more sunlight, the texture is more apparent and the lines can be noticed in the tires as well. Here you can see the video recorded right out of this camera. Its maximum recording capacity is 1080p at 30 fps or frames per second on the back. It's not too shaky, although there's no mention of whether it's got electronic image stabilization. Also, there's no mention of night mode, but I took shots with the Y20 at night. Depending on where you tap on the frame of the image or the viewfinder, which is your screen, before you snap an image, you do get a decent image with enough light, and you notice that some noise is in the image, which is almost inevitable for nighttime images. Keeping this lit signpost in mind, you notice the exposure control is working too at night, since there's a signpost up right there being overexposed to compensate for the rest of the shot. Let me know what your thoughts are about the camera. Those are my thoughts of the Vivo Y20. I did like using it for the while I had it, and Vivo is coming with an interesting presence to Nigeria with the Y series. You have two Y20s. I mentioned Y20 with 3GB and 4GB RAM and 64GB storage. There's a higher Y20S, which is 85,900 Naira, with 120GB of storage. There's also a Y1S for 5,900, Y12S 56,900 Naira. So there's so many options to choose from. they would also be providing support. I fortunately didn't find any bugs or issues. However, I'd implore you guys follow me on social media, Twitter and Instagram. My handles will be displayed for any updates I have on this Y20. Do leave a like if you found this video useful, or drop a comment below if you have any questions. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be talking to you guys in the very next video.